Hey, this is Xander Fryer with Shit You Don't Learn in College, and today I'm gonna talk to you about how I built my seven-figure business. Now, I built my coaching business to our first 100K month within 12 months. So when a lot of our clients hear that, they go, Xander, I wanna do what you did. I wanna get to my first 100K month within 12 months. My first response to most of them is, no, you don't. You don't understand what it actually takes to build to a $1 million business that quickly. But some of them are persistent. They say, no, I do wanna do it. And so I actually run through what I actually had to do to get there with them. Now, because of that, we've had about 15 people that we've helped break the seven-figure mark. And I wanna share with you the seven things that I did differently to get there so fast. Now, the first thing that I tell every single person is you have to have a crystal clear goal on exactly what you want, and you need to use visualization. This is by far one of the most powerful tools when it comes to evoking your most powerful tool, which is your brain. So let's talk about visualization for a second. First, you gotta get clear on what you really want. If you're not super clear on what you want, I knew I wanted to have my first $100,000 month in the coaching space from when I first started. And I visualized that moment every single day for 365 days. Okay, so if you're not crystal clear on exactly what you want, the first thing you gotta do is you gotta get clear. If you're not clear, go buy my book, Shit You Don't Learn in College. We got a bunch of exercises in there for you to run through. A lot of people pay me thousands and thousands of dollars to help them get clarity. You can get everything you need from that little book, Shit You Don't Learn in College. So go to Amazon and grab it right now. Once you have clarity, okay, you're gonna do something called visualizing, which creates cognitive dissonance. Now, what cognitive dissonance is your brain cannot tell the difference between a vividly imagined event and a real event. So when you vividly imagine yourself like I did, walking on stage at an event telling everybody that I just had my first six-figure month in the coaching space just 1 year after I started, I visualize this every single day. It creates this imagined event of me up here, even though my reality is right here. And it's like a rubber band being stretched, right? It creates tension. It creates stress. Now there's two ways to get rid of that tension and that stress, right? To bring these two together. One way is to stop visualizing, to give up on the dream, and your dream will boom, snap back to reality. But if you keep visualizing, you keep feeling that tension and you allow the tension. I want you to remember as we keep digging into this, stress and tension is not bad. Dr. Kelly McGonigal talks about this all the time in her TED talk. Stress is not bad. The belief that stress is bad is what actually kills us. People who live in high stress environments but believe that stress is good actually live longer than people that don't have any stress. So you're creating tension, you're creating stress, but you know that stress is good because it creates growth. And instead of boom, giving up on your dream, you keep that visualization every single day through all the tough times, through all the doubt, but you slowly start acting in alignment with it and reality starts slowly moving forward and moving forward and moving forward and every single day until boom, eventually your reality meets with your dream, not the other way around. Visualization is one of the most powerful things that you can do to create cognitive dissonance and evoke that 95% of your subconscious brain, which is a supercomputer, and will work on solving all of your problems even while you're sleeping. So don't forget to visualize. The second thing that I did is I invested heavily in mentorship. Now, when I went to college, I spent $120,000 to get a college degree from UCLA, which didn't build a life that I really wanted. So why would I hesitate to invest anything less than that in my own personal development when I finally knew what I wanted to do? So in the first 30 days or so of me starting my business, I invested over $35,000 in different mentors, coaches, programs, masterminds to learn absolutely everything that I possibly could. Now, I want you to think of it this way. If you wanted to bake a cake and you've never baked a cake before, would you go try and bake a cake by yourself without anybody to teach you how to bake a cake and no recipe? Probably not, right? Because you'd go to Whole Foods, you'd buy all these ingredients, you mix them all up, you put them in the oven, and you forget the eggs, right? And it'd come out a big ball of mush. So you go back to Whole Foods, you buy some more vanilla extract and a fancy whisk, you do it all again, you put it back, still a big ball of mush. So you think you can't do it. No, it's just because you didn't get a recipe, stupid, right? So go find the people that have done what you want to do and just pay them the money. Invest first and then you will get there. Most people always say, they say, oh, I'll invest in mentorship once I've gotten to XYZ point. That's the stupidest shit in the world. Oh, I'll get a cake recipe after I've baked the cake. Are you fucking kidding me? Seriously, come on, get your logic straight. You have to invest first. Go buy mentorship. I've spent over $500,000 in the last 5 years on my mentorship, and I will never stop because I know how powerful it is. Number three, you gotta get uncomfortable every single day. Now, your subconscious mind craves familiarity, and as soon as you start pushing for more, your subconscious is gonna go, ooh, I don't like that. That's a little too much for me. And it will resist and it will pull you back. And then you'll come back a little bit and it'll go, oh, that's much better. That's right. No, that's not right. That's just familiar. Your subconscious craves familiarity, but your future lives in the unknown, lives in the world of possibility and purpose. So you have to push yourself into the unknown. And what happens when you push yourself into the unknown? It becomes known. It becomes familiar. Every step you take into the unknown, it becomes known. Every step into unfamiliar becomes familiar. That is how you take this dream and turn it into a reality. But if you stay in reality, if you stay in your current known world, you will never be able to create something new. So I need you to realize that every single day you have to get out of your comfort zone. When I first realized this and I launched my business, I told myself, look, I don't know how to build a seven-figure business, but I do know the one truth is I have to become more as a person. I am not good enough yet as a person, and I need to become a seven-figure earner. And in order to become a seven-figure earner, I need to grow. And in order to grow, I need to do uncomfortable shit every single day. So I committed to myself for 1 year, 365 days, I would do what I called my big cojones action. And every single morning, I woke up and I asked myself, what's the one thing that if I did this one thing today, it scared the shit out of me the most, right? That's it. Sometimes that thing made logical sense building the business. Sometimes that thing was a relationship thing. Once it was talking to a good buddy of mine and telling them that they were being kind of toxic in my life and telling them I couldn't hang out with them as much anymore. One was calling an ex-girlfriend and asking her to give feedback on our relationship. Another one was calling my mom and telling her that I needed some space and she couldn't talk to me. Now, I have a Pakistani mom, so for anybody with brown parents, you don't do that to a brown parent, all right? These were really uncomfortable to me. They didn't necessarily make sense business-wise, but it caused me to push myself out of my comfort zone and realize that I wasn't going to die by doing something that scared me. So that when I did go to do things in the business space, like invest in myself, ask for more money, commit to growth, I was able to do it because I was used to getting uncomfortable. You gotta commit to doing something uncomfortable every single day if you wanna grow. Number four is you gotta focus on one thing and one thing only. I'm gonna give you the God honest truth. Balance is bullshit when it comes to launching a business. As an entrepreneur, Charlie Munger, a billionaire, talks about this. When you become an entrepreneur, you need to put every ounce of energy and focus into making that first 100K. Because if you do not, you will not succeed. I want you to think of it like an airplane taking off, right? If you go into an airplane and you give that airplane 50% throttle, is it ever gonna take off that runway? No, what's it gonna do? It's gonna hit the end of the runway and it's gonna either crash and burn or you're gonna have to bail. This is what happens with most people's businesses. They give it 50% throttle and they expect it to take off. Never gonna happen, all right? In entrepreneurship, there's one truth. If you wanna get it to take off, you have to give it 100% throttle. You have to give it everything you've got, all the focus, all the energy that you can put into this to take off. And then once it gets up to cruising altitude, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 feet, then you can pull back. You can pull back to 30% throttle and you can cruise. But to get it to take off, you've got to get everything that you possibly have. So if you're not focused on your business with all your energy there, you've got to get unbalanced. You've got to really go after it. Now, I'm not talking about you can't sleep for 3 straight years. I slept fine. I still worked out. I still had great health. I met the woman of my dreams during that first year. But what I did do is I cut a lot of other stupid shit out of my life. I stopped drinking on weekends. I stopped watching Netflix needlessly. I stopped hanging out with negative people and negative friends and wasting time bickering about stupid shit that didn't matter. I focused my free time on learning, developing, becoming bigger, hanging around people that really mattered, taking care of my health, taking care of my sleep so that I could show up at a different level. I became way more efficient because I cut out all the superfluous bullshit from my life. The number five thing that I did is I became a long-term optimist, but a short-term pessimist. Now, what I mean by that is I truly, deeply believe that for all of us long-term, we can accomplish any of our goals, any of our goals. If you never give up and you keep focusing on growth, you'll get there. You'll get to your goal no matter what. But I was also a short-term pessimist. I was a realist. I didn't just live in the clouds. I looked at reality where it was today, and I had to assess where I was today to figure out how to turn it into the future. The truth is, there are two ways to never achieve your dreams. You can be a realist and never take action towards your dreams, or you could be a dreamer that never lives in the real world. Neither of them accomplish anything. I want you to think of your dream as the engine of a train. And I want you to think of reality as the payload that is attached to this train. Now, dreamers disconnect the engine and drive off on their own to their destination, but they leave the payload behind. They go live in the dream world in their brain, but they never bring reality with it. And realists feel this engine pulling on them and they go, fuck that, I don't want to do that. Let that engine go, right? And so they just sit here, they just slam on the brakes and they leave the payload in its current location, right? These are two of the same ways to make sure that your dreams never become reality. The truth is, if you can keep the dream connected to reality, one hand in the sky while the other is firmly planted on earth, you can slowly start to bring reality to your dream. It takes work, it takes effort, it's hard. That's why most people don't do it. Most people would prefer to sever the connection. But if you keep them connected and you keep working at it, eventually you'll get there. Number six is something that I call working hard, not necessarily long. All right, now I want you to understand that there is a difference between working hard and working long hours. Now I don't work 100 hours a week, right? But the work that I do, I work my ass off and it's very courageous. I make scary decisions, I make tough decisions every single day, I have difficult conversations every single day, and I make the decisions that other people don't want to make, and I put in the time, the energy, and focus while I am working. Right? There's a difference between working long and working hard. Now, I would rather be 100% focused and make the courageous decisions for 40 hours a week than work 100 hours a week, 50% focused, and making uncourageous, fearful decisions. One's gonna lead you towards success and free time to do shit that you love with your loved ones, and one's gonna lead you to burnout and being unhappy with not a lot of stuff, right? Work hard, not necessarily long. And then the last thing that I want to remind you is to never give up. Like I mentioned, one of the biggest issues with people when it comes to building their business is they have this attachment and expectation of what it's actually going to take. And most of the time, your expectations of what it's actually going to take are a little bit fluffy and definitely wrong. Expect it to take longer, expect it to be harder, expect it to push you even more and to have to face more fears than you ever thought possible. And if you expect that, and then you realize, I'm not gonna give up no matter what, then there's only one outcome. If it's not gonna kill you, you focus on growing and getting better, and you never give up, you have to succeed. In the end, that's what it takes. See, I'm just being honest. In the end, building financial freedom is not easy. If it were, everybody would do it. But if you're willing to follow these principles and really master these principles, you'll get there, I promise. That's all we got for this video. If you liked it, be sure to hit the like button below. If you have a specific topic you want me to cover in a future video, let me know in the comments below as well. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button as well, so you never miss another great video, and I'll see you in there.